As a film producer, you spend a lot of your life looking for stories. So it dawned on me, perhaps slightly slowly, that I was sitting on a story that I knew an awful lot about. But I was very trepidatious about trying to bring it to the screen because there would be nothing worse than making a family biopic that you didn't like yourself. So I went about it very slowly, and the first ingredient was the writer. I saw a play called Shadowlands some years ago, written by Bill Nicholson, which I adored and cried all the way through. And it had the right tone, I felt, for the story that I wanted to tell. I then worked with Bill on a film, Elizabeth Golden Age, and afterwards I asked him if he would write this story, and he said that he would, but on one condition. And that condition, which is a lovely thing for a producer to hear, is he said, don't pay me until and unless the film happens. So I thought, okay, that's very good. His logic being, this is your story, so it mustn't fall into the hands of anybody else. It mustn't be controlled by anybody else. So we worked on the script for many years in between Bill's other jobs and assignations. And then the critical ingredient was bringing on Andy Serkis as the director, who introduced all sorts of other elements to the script beyond what Bill and I had developed. But the critical thing, which came together last year, was finding the two people who Andy and I felt would best and most beautifully portray my parents, and here they are. And the moment that we met them both, we knew that we had to make the film. It's a very rare situation, you know, when you make a film that you actually don't look back on it with any regret in any frame of it. I'm particularly grateful for these two because it wasn't just that they got the spirit of my parents. They somehow encapsulated them. And Claire spent quite a lot of time with my mother, and they have similarities of character, perhaps. But for Andrew to recreate somebody who has been dead for 23 years was just, to me and to anybody who knew my father, literally extraordinary. About 3 weeks before we started shooting, I was checking my messages, and I got a message from my father using all the words that he used to call me Jay, and I was completely overwhelmed and frankly confused, slow-wittedly. And at the end, the voice said, "How was that?" And of course, it was him. And it was an extraordinary thing. I have one regret, which is really a regret of my mother's. When we showed my mother a clip of the film for the first time, my mother loves the film, thank God. We showed her a sort of 5-minute clip, and I said, "Don't say anything, just watch it through." It's a bit of, you know, quite a big thing for her. And halfway through, she'd been keeping it in as long as she can. She said, "Oh, I would never have worn that hat," which was the hat she wore in the hospital. So that is my regret, that we allowed her to wear the hat.
And how did she feel about the film, Jonathan?
Well, she absolutely loves the film. I mean, the first time she watched it, she was terrified, which I've never seen before, actually. It's the first time in my life, interestingly, that I've seen her frightened. She said, "I've decided to take the view that this film is not about me at all." So I went, "Okay, that's probably why." And she was sort of in shock, I think, because everything had come back in a most extraordinarily powerful way. She's seen it a couple of times since, and she does absolutely love it. It also is the first thing I've ever done that has validated my own professional life. My mother and I started a charity called CS Disabled Holidays some time ago, which provides grants for severely disabled people to allow them to go on holiday. Because obviously what we don't think about so much is that disabled people need holidays more than anybody else does, and they are probably less likely to be able to go on them for lack of resources and lack of care and everything else. And because my father's huge belief was in quality of life for people like himself, that's what he fought his life for. Once he had arranged a way for himself and my mother and me to have a good life, he then turned his attention to helping everybody else. And in a very small way, that's what we're trying to do with this charity. But we're also involved with the polio eradication regime, the Polio Fellowship, all sorts of other organisations who hopefully will profit from the general awareness of severe disability that this film throws up.